wants to stay.
The other is desperate to go.
This house makes me feel like spitting feathers.
I love the house.
Where's the three bedrooms that we actually need?
I'm on Team Love It, because I want to help people to make the most of their existing homes.
It's stunning.
Why didn't you think of this, love?
Meanwhile, I say listing it is the only way to get what you want.
What of you?
That's actually amazing, isn't it?
Tonight, it's our final battle of the series. And believe me, there'll be blood.
Which brings us to the question.
Will you love it?
Or will you list it?
But with the score standing at four loves...
We're going to love it.
To love it.
Live here for a bit longer.
To my three lists.
Listed.
You beautiful, beautiful man.
You are kidding me.
Watch out, Allsop. This contest could end in a draw.
I can't lose again. I won't lose again.
A draw. It's losing by another name. It's not good enough for me.
You may be staring defeat in the face, Phil.
Yeah, I'm looking at you.
Let battle commence.
This week, we're in the heart of London, practically in the Thames, with a flat of all things.
It's in the super central district of Wapping, where a three-bed terrace can set you back £1 million, and prices have leapt by 11% in the last year alone.
Mind you, driving's a nightmare, as is my navigator.
You're the one with the most opinions on which way we're supposed to be going.
I think we're here somewhere. It's quite complicated.
Are you lost, Phil, in Wapping?
Well, I'm following your directions, so if I'm lost,
I didn't say. I believe I said try that way or that way, which doesn't specify as directions.
Not an awful lot of help to then accuse me of getting it wrong.
I didn't ever see the memo which said be of help to Phil.
I would hope that you wouldn't have to see a memo be of help to Phil, eh?
Actually, Phil, I am here to help, as are you, because project manager Gareth Hearn, wife Tina and admin manager are struggling to make one very big decision.
I can't see us growing up here as a family at all.
I feel that this place works.
They might be at loggerheads now, but when they bought this two-storey apartment in 2006, they were on the same page.
They scrimped, saved and managed to secure it for £395,000, renting out the spare bedrooms to help make their dreams come true.
I remember when we first got the keys and I came to the little backyard and I was sitting there and I was like, I can't believe I own a little place, we own a little place in London that's got an apple tree in the backyard. Because growing up in New Zealand, it's all about having big backyards with fruit trees and I loved it.
They left London to work in India 10 years ago, but now they're back with two children and a headache about where to base themselves.
You're the one that wanted to move back here in the first place.
I wanted to move back to the UK. Yeah. This was a stepping stone.
So you just dangled a carrot to get me back here.
Yes, very, very clever of me.
Mum Tina thinks the setting is perfect for a busy working family.
One of the big things I love about this place is the fact that it still allows us to get the kids to school and for me to walk to work. I know that it will take me half an hour door to door, guaranteed.
But Dad Gareth dreams of a bigger home in the suburbs.
I feel that a family home is, how I grew up. It's either a semi or it's a detached house with a little bit more space and a nice greenery around it. I don't see us growing up and growing old here together.
I think a family home is wherever your family is. You make the most of where you are.
I don't even like gardening, but I see myself mowing the lawn on a Sunday.
I bet the novelty of that will wear off very quickly and he'll be on his phone trying to get a guy in.
Nothing wrong with getting a guy in, except last time they tried to renovate, it didn't work out well and they abandoned the project.
It's no great secret that I am immensely indecisive, especially when it comes to big decisions like this.
Fear not, we're here to help.
Oh, look, here's someone coming. They've come right down to greet us. That's very civilised.
What do you think? They buzz us in.
Yes. Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
nice to meet you.
Good morning.
Hello.
How are you doing?
We're very well, thank you.
How are you doing? Nice to meet you.
Oh, this is great. We haven't done a flat before.
Well, welcome.
We're excited to see
you. You're here to help, are you?
Well, allegedly.
I'm here to help. She's just here for glamour.
Someone needs to make an effort, Phil. This flat is full of potential, with three bedrooms upstairs and the garage space and living areas downstairs, which is how the family tend to come and go, through the garden right onto the bank of the Thames.
A beautiful river indeed, but they do have to share it with London's 8.6 million other inhabitants.
So what's the trouble? What's the problem?
The core problem is city versus suburb. That's what you're going to face, Ryan. I would like to move to the suburbs. I think it's time to grow as a family. And for me, it's just not a home.
Very, very sensible words,
I think so.
Absolutely spot on. What could be the problem? Tina, why are you so set on being here?
To me, it's more about the kids and how I would work that with the kids. I love the location. Here, you can walk to every activity. She's got swimming, she's got trampoline, she's got ballet, she's got drama. All within a 5-minute walk.
As a working mum who managed to drop her kids at school this morning and got the tube here, what you've just said is absolutely the thing. And if Phil could find a property near enough that you were still able to do that, then that's amazing.
Phil's the man, right?
That I am, Gareth. And because this flat was bought so long ago, and this is central London where house prices have risen by up to 65% in just the last 8 years, if the family did sell up and pursue a life away from the big smoke, they'd have a budget of £1.1 million to work with.
That's a huge amount of money, but as many have found to their peril, our capital doesn't get you much bang for your buck. Plus, on top of that, Tina and Gareth would be shelling out just under £54,000 in stamp duty and another £20,000 or so in legal and moving costs.
I think that you are going to really, really struggle.
They can now afford a bigger property.
Yeah, but
so why are they crunched in here
but they're
with
not,
four
of course, but
living
actually,
in this room?
No
playroom?
No, but Phil, that's what's absolutely extraordinary. And this is at the heart of everyone's property dilemmas. Square footage does not guarantee better family life.
What? You mean size isn't everything?
You know the first thing I would do if I were them?
What?
You're going to laugh. I'm going to tell you this. This is absolutely the first thing I would do. I would get a hot tub. There's nothing children like more than a hot tub.
Privacy or what?
No,
I mean, about a million people could look.
Suit. It doesn't matter. You're in a bathing suit in a hot tub.
Oh, come on.
I had no idea you were so shy, Phil. I'm sure you look lovely in your budgie smugglers.
I can't get away from, and I shouldn't because I know there'll be lots of families living around here, but it's very densely populated.
But Phil, you're a Kentish person. You're a man of Kent.
Gareth
and you
is
think
in the
happiness
same spot.
Is rolling acres of green, green grass.
I wish he wouldn't say it like that. He wants it to feel homely and spacious for his girls.
And why would I not be able to do that?
Because it's small.
It's not
and
that
dark.
Small.
And wait for it, it's a leasehold. Which means, in Gareth and Tina's case, you can't change anything that affects the exterior of the property. No extra windows, no change in the garage entrance, no extensions.
All perfectly doable, if you know how.
I've been dealing with leasehold flats for many a year. Long in the tooth when it comes to leasing.
Yeah, you're just long in the tooth.
The correct thing to do here is make sure any proposed changes are run past the freeholder.
And that we can get a work permit. In this case, it's not so much about how the family use their home now as redesigning it so it works for the future as well.
If you can get Gareth to sign off your plan.
That's not what he said.
He wants to live in the suburbs.
No, he doesn't want to live in the suburbs. He wants to be proud. If you showed him a £3 million house in Wapping, he wouldn't say, oh, Phil, I'd rather the suburbs.
That's true.
He wants a bit of space and he wants to feel proud.
If a house that's worth more than £800,000 can't make you feel proud, then frankly, we should all be moving to the suburbs.
It's very well designed. There's three or four things I need to do.
One of her more bonkers ideas was she's going to set you up with a hot tub in the garden. She thinks that'll entertain the children forever. No, I say it will entertain about a million neighbours.
I think, well, you're just a prude. You're a snob, you're obsessed with being in the country,
Dave,
and you're
listen,
a prude.
I'm trying to help, not throw insults around the house.
I'm glad someone pickers more than us.
They've given me a Lovett budget of £75,000, which is roughly what they'd spend on moving costs and taxes. The garage is full of potential, and I have big ideas for that small kitchen. I also need to address the dated bathrooms.
At the very least, it'll make this place more saleable when they do decide to list it.
We have to sort this out. I'm not convinced it's for the long term. You're in a good position in life and you've got a nice budget, and we can go and explore and find you what you could get.
With a budget of around 1.1 million, I need to find a family home with four bedrooms and green space. High-achieving schools are a must for Gareth, but I also have to keep Tina within a 30 to 40 minute commute of her work in central London. Easy, right?
I think Phil's going to find a wonderful place and is really going to change your mind.
Can't move location.
Everyone is really digging in.
No, they're not digging in. You keep on saying you're both so entrenched.
Well, no, you're really digging in. She's really digging in.
It's
boys against girls at this point.
It's not boys against girls. No, not anybody against anybody.
Mm. Kirstie's going to do up this place beautifully.
We have a dilemma which we need to sort out. I think the real issue is your urban snobbery.
She's so full of
sugar and spice and all things nice.
To make me consider moving from here, Phil would have to come up with something fairly spectacular.
She believes the space is good enough and big enough, and I disagree.
In Wapping, East London, a young family are torn between city centre convenience and the seduction of suburban space.
Go to our friends' houses. Some people have just bought outside of central London. I have house envy. I have home envy more than anything.
Phil was definitely going to have his work cut out. It's the location, that's the issue for me. You can't move the location.
Precisely. I think they should stay. So it's my mission to transform this tired flat into a functioning family home so they can love it once more.
Do you know, it is really amazing to have this space. Phil's not going to be able to find a house with a garage this size. Or off-street parking.
That's not entirely true. High-achieving state schools are the number one priority for Tina and Gareth. So, yes, even the £1.1 million budget I've been given doesn't always stretch to four bedrooms, a garden and off-street parking. But research has found that house prices in the London commuter belt fall by more than £3,000 for every minute further away they are by train from the capital. So factor in a 30-minute commute or longer, and you can start to see just how much Tina and Gareth could get for their money.
So my plan of the day is to actually stretch the boundaries quite far, because I want to show them to start with how much more property they could get for their money if they spent a bit more time on the train. It is a bit of a gamble. I don't know how it's going to go, but I think it's a sensible place to start.
For our first property, we're going south to Purley Oaks, 50 minutes from Tina and Gareth's work via Croydon. But this is suburban living at its finest. I'm just hoping I can convince Tina that the lifestyle benefits for the family far outweigh the extra commute time.
It's definitely further out than we imagined, but I was going to say wait to see what Phil's magic has come up with.
What do you think, Tina?
My mummy said if you didn't have anything nice to say, don't say anything.
You're very well brought up.
Not the most auspicious of starts. My plan could backfire here spectacularly.
So what it means, if you were to travel the extra, what would it be, 15 minutes or so, you'd get a detached house with its own driveway. Well, there's a surprise in the garden, but actually that is the nursery.
Very good, very good.
That's the first smile of the day.
Despite sitting well under budget at £875,000, this is double the size of their current flat. It's a detached Edwardian home with three reception rooms, six bedrooms, private parking, and, wait for it, an outdoor swimming pool, which blows Kirstie's hot tub idea out of the water. This should be a real eye-opener for Tina and Gareth in terms of what they can get for their money if they do compromise on the commute.
Spot. Dining room, formal separate dining room, massive living room with its fireplace and things. Down into the kitchen.
It's massive, it's enormous.
And I love the flow for the little eating area, play area onto the garden. That's something that I really wanted.
So far, so good.
Lots of lovely trees.
Oh my God, there's
space
the surprise.
To play, and there is the surprise.
Oh mate.
Heated swimming pool.
There's the jacuzzi that Kirstie wanted to put in our tiny little backyard.
Slightly bigger, isn't it?
Yes. I trounce Kirstie at every moment.
Yeah.
Kirstie said to me that she felt extra square footage doesn't necessarily make a kind of happy family home. I mean, just first impressions of this. Is that something you'd agree with?
It's definitely a family home. I mean, that's one of the things that I was talking about from the start.
I mean, it's big. I just don't know if you need a heated swimming pool in England.
I'm sure your children would disagree, Tina. I took a gamble on this house. But
I see your hot tub and I raise it to a swimming pool.
Although perhaps I showed my hand too soon.
A little old-fashioned with the attire.
I just wouldn't pay extra for period features, like some people love period features. I just don't know if it's our style.
Tina, what are your thoughts?
I guess if this was a house that was completely done up and you walked in and went, wow, you wouldn't have to do a thing, that would be more appealing for me. It's not the commute that's put me off. It's more the amount of work that would need to be done.
But it's nothing that you wouldn't expect of a house of this age. I wanted to show you this as an example. If you commuted a little bit further,
yeah.
That what you could get.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It really is crazy.
Yeah.
So period style is not to their taste. But if the work transforming it into a contemporary home is Tina's only concern, then this viewing has been a big success.
I'm really happy with my opening gambit because it stimulated some proper debate between them. Before, Tina was adamant she would not commute more than 30 minutes, and now they're discussing it. So I think it's gone well.
And I know exactly what to show them for property number two. Prepare to be wowed, Tina.
In Wapping, I've been hard at work coming up with a design that will make Tina and Gareth love their flat again.
It works, this kitchen. But it's dark, it's tucked away, it's not very friendly. You know, you've got your back to everybody. So I think what I want to do is kind of draw it into the light.
To transform this professional's pad into a loving family home for four, I'm working to a budget of £75,000.
This is your flat. It is huge.
Huge.
Huge for London, huge for within the M25, actually.
Space isn't the only issue here. The problem is that this flat has not been designed with a family in mind. But it's all very fixable. A simple rejig of the bedrooms will create more space, and two updated bathrooms will modernise the upstairs no end. Downstairs, by adding a stud wall to their underutilised garage, I'll be creating two spaces. One offering masses of storage, and the other an indoor play area for the girls. Perfect for hobbies, as it will come complete with an insulated timber floor. And finally, their old kitchen is going to be replaced and extended into the current living room, transforming mealtimes into a sociable family occasion.
In terms of what I'm suggesting, does anything fill you with horror?
No. I'm impressed. I like the idea that it will come in at less money.
Making use of this area, it just makes it a little bit bigger. It makes it more like three bedrooms upstairs and the space of three bedroom kind of flat downstairs.
I think it does function at the moment, actually, but it doesn't make Gareth proud. And I think that's quite important. I know that there have been problems with decision making. You have been down this route before. If you decide to go ahead with it, I need to say to you, right, you've got a week in which to move around the furniture, go on the websites, make it your focus as a family. Show the girls the pictures of the various bedrooms. Really go for it visually on the things that you like. Because this is a really well-built flat. It doesn't need a designer. It needs you and your knowledge of how you get in and out the door every day.
If they go with my basic plan, it should cost around £50,000. And given the restrictions with the leasehold, which means I can't change the exterior makeup, I'm pretty proud of my solution. But Gareth doesn't look 100% convinced.
I've not been swayed at the moment, because I always like to see two sides of an argument before I make a decision.
Well, it's a rejig, and hopefully it will just make it that much nicer and refreshed, though, but without going to a ridiculous expense on it.
It's 10 whole weeks later, but I'm thrilled to say the renovations are finally underway. The family have decided to move out. The kitchen and bathroom have been gutted. And a wall has been knocked out.
But not everyone is as happy as Kirstie.
It's very unusual to see my house like this, or our house like this.
Wait, is this our bathroom?
Yeah. It's both our bathrooms.
Probably shouldn't say this, but I'm hoping that Gareth will get complacent, if not change his mind. He'll just be so happy with how the place is for now that he won't realise that the years are ticking by.
Oh, she's cunning. But I've also been putting in some spade work, and I think I've found a property that even Tina will get excited about. In southeast London, on the banks of the River Thames, lies the Royal Borough of Greenwich, a maritime district steeped in majestic history and landscaped greenery. Add to this a door-to-door commute of 40 minutes, and I think I'm onto a winner here.
Tina, I've been really pleased with how you've reacted, because I thought it was just going to be a bit of a kind of brick wall.
If you had said on paper, you know, move out past Croydon, like when we were looking in the train station on the map, I'm like, wow. But then you do see what you can get, you weigh it up, you're saying like that nursery was just across the road.
I'm just really pleased that you are weighing it up rather than just kind of blanket.
Stuck in the mud.
Which is, forgive me, but that's kind of what I was expecting. But I don't know what gave me that.
Put the shovel down, Phil. I think you've made your point.
So Greenwich is a very, very different kettle of fish. Short walk to the station, literally a few minutes, and then it's 19 minutes on the train into Cannon Street, which would give you a total journey, probably by the time you've walked into the office, 35, 40 minutes. Something
definitely
like that.
Doable.
While this might not be the detached property Gareth dreams of, inside, it's been lovingly renovated to the kind of spec you'd expect for £1.1 million. Yes, it's at the top of their budget, but it has four good-sized bedrooms, a cloakroom, bath and shower room, manageable garden, and that family-friendly, open-plan, downstairs living space they need. If Gareth wants a home he can be proud of, it doesn't get much more luxurious than this.
So good built-in storage, downstairs loo, and through to a really spectacular kitchen.
It's really nice.
It's got underfloor heating, it's got clever lighting, it's got music in the ceiling, two ovens.
Nice.
It's immaculate.
My first impression of walking in here was wow. Lovely family room, very social.
Yeah.
I love the brickwork as well.
Yes.
Exposed brickwork, I think it's great.
It smiles all round. Let's see if the bedrooms get the same reaction.
I know you wanted somewhere that was going to be light and bright, so You couldn't get a lighter room than this.
Beautiful.
Overlooking an award-winning park, this house is a stone's throw away from a nursery and kids' club. But my real pièce de résistance is yet to come.
That end of the park, that building there, is a outstanding primary school.
Fabulous.
What do you think, Tina?
I think it's great. I think it's lovely.
Could you see yourself living here?
Yeah, I could.
Or somewhere like this.
Yeah, I definitely could if I had to move. This is hardly a compromise.
This house seems to be winning Tina over.
For a London house, it doesn't get much better than this.
The only suboptimal is the lack of designated parking.
Yes. I think you've both stepped towards one another. Tina, you're considering the commute, and Gareth, you're considering living in a terraced house. So this is what this whole process is designed to do, is to bring you closer together and able to make your confident decision together at the end of it.
It's food for thought all round, and I now know where my next property search is headed.
Their conclusion has been to move the search geographically further out. They're both happy to extend the commute and try and get more property for less money.
What's more, it's Tina who's pushing for it.
You kind of go, well, if we're moving from Wapping, is this enough? Like, I don't know, I think maybe, is there a
Is there something in the middle, a happy medium?
Mm-hmm. A little bit more space.
Further out, though.
But with a decent commute.
Yeah.
Tina and I are notorious in our family, within our friends, to be unable to make a decision on pretty much anything.
We were abroad for 7 years. We didn't do anything because the rent kept coming in. When we came back, it was very tired. We had these grand ideas, but then spent the next 18 months bickering about what we were or weren't going to do with it.
Fortunately, Tina, an admin manager, and Gareth, a project manager, now have Phil and I to help guide them through the process of deciding whether to love or list their three-bedroom maisonette in Wapping.
So far, I've shown them two properties, and I think opened Tina's eyes to a whole new world outside of Wapping.
If I had to move, this is hardly a compromise.
Surely not, Tina. Remember, you can't beat the location of your Wapping flat. And I'm determined to convince Gareth too that this can work as a family home that he can be proud of.
I'm back in London to see how Tina and Gareth are getting on with their build. It took quite a while to decide what, if any, work they were going to do to their flat. But now the decisions are rolling in, much to the relief of their builder.
And they've been fairly rattling through my plan. Downstairs, there was once a dark cave of a kitchen, but now it's a much more open space. And what was once a drafty and unloved garage is now the beginnings of an indoor play area for daughters Jacinta and Kayla.
Well, this is a house that's been torn to shreds. Nothing's been put in, this room hasn't been decorated, it hasn't been furnished, and yet it already feels utterly and totally different.
Yeah, well, yeah, no. This actually, opening this out has made a big difference.
It makes a huge difference, doesn't it? When you're standing here, you absolutely, your line of sight is absolutely straight through, feels very free and clear and open.
When you're doing renovations, it's not just a case of signing off architects' plans and letting the builders get on with it. They need to know where you want your lights, your plug points, your appliances, and which kitchen you're getting. In Gareth and Tina's case, a very high-end one, I hear.
There's a lot going on in this flat. A hell of a lot. It doesn't entirely look to me like 50 grand's worth of work. Have you totally let go of the budget?
We looked at the all the different builders and
just say yes.
The budget, from my point of view, it's I always figured it would be about 10% of the property price, and I think it may go a little bit over that.
Well, we're in now. There's no backing out. You're going to spend this much. Why not now? Just get the things that you really like that will really make it kind of what you want in life and make it all worthwhile.
The more you spend here, the less likely you are to move, and I...
The builders here wanted many design decisions made up front before they started work. Not easy for a couple who admit to chronic indecision. One thing they've yet to settle on is lighting. But that's where I come in. Tina and Gareth may be polar opposites when choosing where to live, but hopefully they'll find some common ground today.
It's a funny thing, lighting. Often when it's really bad, you don't realise how bad it is until you get it right. It really is something that you should bother with and take time over, because it can make all the difference. Just to give me an idea, Tina, looking around this room, which is the thing that you find most attractive?
Well, to your point...
Of course. OK. Gareth aside, what do you find most attractive in this room? Do you tend to like metallicised things or things which are going to sort of more mould in, like painted white that or painted the same colour as your walls?
I personally found the more chromey.
The chromey stuff. Okie doke.
Personally.
Tina?
She likes to be different to me.
Yeah, no, I'm not sure about these track lighting spots where, because that's effectively what we've got now, and I find that at some points you're blinded by it.
Oh dear, it looks like living arrangements aren't the only thing they can't agree on.
This caught my eye as soon as we came in.
I really like this.
I love it, but it doesn't fit in with anything else we've got going on. Actually, I think the light should just blend in. We should stop trying to find this funky feature light that's going to be a statement.
No, I think.
And actually go, let's just blend in.
They may not be able to agree on fittings, but in a country where 37% of us consider strip lighting to be our worst DIY disaster, at least they're giving it proper thought. The solution for lighting a large kitchen diner come living room, like Gareth and Tina's, is zoning, according to how you use the space. In your kitchen, go bright over your worktops. Super efficient LED products could save up to £240 a year on your electricity bill. And over your dining table, use dimmer switches so you can create different moods to suit different occasions.
I've always wanted one of these lit-up magnifying mirrors, but I've just discovered a new wrinkle above my left eyebrow which I didn't know I had, so maybe not. No one at any point today has said, what if we sell? Doesn't seem to be part of their mindset at the moment.
On to my final property, where I will show admin and project managers Tina and Gareth that Wapping isn't the only option for good schools, kids' clubs and great transport links. Historically, Beckenham was a proper Kentish town. After the railways, it was reclassed as a London borough. Best of both worlds then, wouldn't you say?
Morning.
Hello.
Morning. How are you doing?
Good.
Nice to see you both.
Nice to see you.
All well?
Very well.
Tina, are you OK here in Beckenham? Yeah, you're not getting any nosebleeds or anything?
No, this isn't too far out.
Although technically we are further out of town, because this is the direct train into City Thames Link, it's only 23 minutes, which is going to keep your door-to-door commute under half an hour.
That's exactly what we're aiming for. That's perfect.
23 minutes. Definitely do that.
Yeah?
A good start. And as the property's just a couple of minutes' walk away, I thought we'd do things the old-fashioned way, on foot.
And we're on this street here, down here.
Oh, wow, a lovely tree-lined street.
And, more importantly...
with an outstanding infant school at the end of it.
Oh, is that a school?
With the station.
Right there.
And we have a lovely house that's under budget.
There's got to be some catch.
No, there is no catch, I promise.
Have a little faith, Tina.
Gareth, what's going through your mind?
Got the off-street parking. House is very pretty. A minute from the train station.
What's not to like, eh?
No, it's like a half an hour to get into London.
There's got to be a catch. I keep saying it, but there's got to be something wrong with it.
No, just a stunning extended Victorian property set in a family-orientated location that even hosts its own street party every year. It's split over three levels. Downstairs, it boasts two large reception rooms, including an incredible kitchen dining space similar to the spec of the Greenwich property they like so much. Upstairs, there are four beds and a beautiful family bathroom. Out back, there's a great-sized garden perfect for Jacinta and Kayla. And at £950,000, it's £150,000 under budget.
Because I love the flow of this place. It's been extended out back here into something that I'd say is quite special.
Oh, it's got one of these.
I think they've done a really, really good job on it. Loads of space. Look at the size of that wine fridge. Coffee machine. You know, it's a very well specced out place. Look at that. Could you see yourself here?
Oh, yeah.
Entertaining family and friends. You're trying... now you're trying not to like it. Your gut reaction was you loved it, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
And now you're going, oh, what am I letting myself in for?
No, it is lovely.
This is a beautiful room. This is a bit like, you know, for entertaining.
Have you seen it at
the back? Yes, I have.
Crikey, Tina's enthused, and I'm shocked.
If you wanted to find a criticism, that's it. That is the railway. But it is an electric railway, yeah, so it's not noisy.
Mm-hmm.
I'd have to hear it, but I haven't heard anything so far.
What the lady wants...
Here we come.
Oh, my gosh, that is nothing. That is nothing.
That's nothing, is it?
Yeah, that was crazy.
It's not going to wake a sleeping child. It's not going to disturb you whilst you're in the garden.
And there's more.
Palm tree?
Well, you know, I had to bring... an Antipodean little bit into it. Ran in here this morning and planted that for you. There's a gum tree down the end, you know. Got it all going on. Well, they both are being really positive and upbeat, particularly Tina, and she's the one that doesn't want to move. But then I have found a really nice house within a 30-minute commute door to door, so could all be going my way.
There is one minor drawback, though.
Yeah, so it's one bathroom. But nice bathroom.
Very nice bathroom. Two toilets.
Yeah.
Toilet.
Yeah.
Best one yet, by far, I think.
I agree, but have I done enough to bring Tina over to Team Listed?
Could it convince you out of Whopping?
It's convinced me.
I like this house and I like all the things it brings to the table, the off-street parking, the private road, the nice big garden, the train doesn't bother me. I'm really enthusiastic.
Kirstie said it couldn't be done, and I've managed to find the right house within the 30-minute commute time.
I don't know about you, but I love it. I mean,
Phil has done an amazing job.
Yeah, I think this is the one house out of the three that I would actually consider, you know, buying.
Yeah, I agree.
Hang on, Tina. You've not seen the finished product at home yet.
We're back in Whopping. As today, project manager Gareth Hares and his wife, admin manager Tina Woodger, will finally settle their argument over city versus suburbs.
I feel that this place works.
I can't see us growing up here as a family at all.
To convince Gareth to love their flat by the Thames, the last 9 weeks have been spent remodelling it in order to create the perfect home for a family of four.
It's very unusual to see my house like this or our house like this.
Meanwhile, I've tried to sell Tina on the many, many benefits of moving to a new way of life.
That is the nursery.
Very good, very good.
That's the first smile of the day.
But with the renovation complete and the score standing at four loves to Phil's three lists, we're both desperate to know what Gareth and Tina plan to do now.
There's the building.
The flat.
You'll be amazed, Phil.
Well, you'd be amazed if you could see the houses I showed them, and they were amazed.
And how long would it take me to get to those houses?
Yeah, one of them was half an hour. A couple of them were half an hour.
You would get to the station, wait for the train, get on the train.
Well,
I know you're quite confident about this, Phil.
Well, I wouldn't say confident, but I am hopeful. Yes, I am definitely
but
hopeful.
But I think your chipperness is going to end up in the chipper.
Right. What's this? For all, here we come. Come on, baby, come on. Move out of this flat.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
Oh, look.
Hi.
Oh, two people in their business suits.
Looking very smart.
That's because they live close to their place of
work.
Yeah,
all right,
come
on.
Indeed, exactly. I had to walk back.
When we first met Gareth and Tina, like many city dwellers, they had a fabulous location, but not a lot of space. And with daughters, Jacinta and Kayla, growing up fast, the problem was only getting worse. Though where things really came unstuck was in that small, dark and family-unfriendly kitchen. But now, thanks to a little lateral thinking on the layout, not only do we have incredibly stylish open-plan living...
Blimey.
My word, that looks fantastic.
We also have a brand new kitchen that's more than 1.5 times the size of the old one.
This is pretty snazzy, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm slightly beyond budget, I feel.
Double oven?
Wi-Fi, I can start it on my way home from work.
No.
You're kidding?
Not that I know how yet.
And I love the breakfast bar. And the girls can then sit and watch me burn whatever I'm burning.
Yeah.
Salad.
Yeah, burn salad.
And let's be dead honest, joking aside, it's just a bit flash. It looks lovely. It's sleek. It looks expensive. It probably was expensive. But it's proud. You'd be proud to have people here.
I completely agree with everything that's being said. But it's only half the size of some of those houses.
Half the size, half the commute.
Yeah.
No.
And let's look.
Not true.
True.
As you well know, not true.
Though, of course, there's now no reason to go anywhere, because as well as the fabulous open-plan living, we've also stretched the budget just a little to completely revamp the garden.
making this floor perfect for family time and socialising.
It is a total transformation without actually officially knocking down any walls.
Yeah, no structural changes.
I mean, that's what's so essentially, there have been no structural changes. This is the same room. We just, the arch has been taken out.
And a little bit there.
And now it's much more open. We can see what they're doing.
We've got people over. It's not like you're kind of hidden away in the kitchen. Not that I'm the one, poor little woman in the kitchen, but, you know, and whoever is in the kitchen, either of us, you're then still able to talk to
really
people.
Really convivial social space, you know.
I've got to ask, would you be able to keep it like this? I mean, it looks stunning.
Yeah. No, let's be honest, once our children and our stuff are back here, it will be a tip.
But we know when it's tidy, it looks great.
Fortunately, clutter will never be a problem in this house again, as the former garage has been divided in two, giving Mum and Dad masses of storage and the girls a play area for Britain's odd rainy day.
Okay.
So this is the garage.
Yes.
It can easily be converted back to garage use. That's just a stud wall, so that
absolutely
comes down.
That was the purpose of the design. But we can also double it up to somewhere if the kids can come in and have a little play if it's raining, or a bit of a hobby room or whatever.
Just a bit more space for the kids.
Yeah.
And upstairs, there are more clever space solutions. A brand new, bigger family bathroom, plus an ensuite that's doing a better job too.
Very smart ensuite. It's two sinks.
Cool. Yeah, a double sink in such a tiny room. That design changed probably about how many times? So many times.
Is that your decisiveness?
Yes.
Or indecisiveness?
Yeah, indecisiveness.
Gareth and Tina aren't alone. Most of us struggle with the hundreds of decisions renovating involves. But my advice is simple.
It would be to go away and to sit down with all the catalogues, with no children and no phones and no distractions, and just make every single decision ahead of time. But also...
And then get rid of the books.
Get rid of the books. Make your decisions...
You said that with feeling.
Yeah. Make the decisions, stick with the decisions. Yeah.
But are you pleased with the decisions that you've taken?
If it makes him happy and gets us to stay, then I'm happy.
Oh, here we go. This is going to be difficult.
Some might say impossible, Phil. And while at £90,000, Gareth and Tina have gone over budget, the good news is that they've added £130,000 or so to the flat's value.
Which means they're in an even stronger position to sell up and move on. Thank you, sweet cheeks. Loving your work.
What you've done is amazing. In a relatively small space, you've made it feel bigger, lighter, more usable. And it's great. But it still begs the question, can it be the long-term family home?
The location of this place is amazing. When you're young professionals, why wouldn't you want to live here? But to your point, maybe it's not our forever home.
Square footage does not necessarily make for a better family life.
I can't help noticing there's one thing missing that I was expecting. Where's the hot tub? You said there was going to be a hot tub. When I showed you a house with a blooming great swimming pool.
You did. That was beautiful.
And it opened our eyes, didn't it?
It did. And it was just going to some of those places that we would never have considered.
Go on, Phil. Get it opened up.
Okay. At the end of all of this, will you love it?
Or list it?
Is there a third option? Both?
Mm-hmm.
Can you let it?
Yes, absolutely you could let it.
Listing or letting in the future, when we think it's not working any longer for our family, for our girls, for schooling.
But for the moment, where we are right now in our lives, we're going to love it.
We're both working, it works for us, the girls are happy.
And this is now a place that I'm super happy to be.
Which is great, because you're both on the same page, finally.
That is something to celebrate. Here's to being on the same page.
Well done.
Cheers.
Sorry, Phil. Technically, that's my fifth love it.
Not so fast, Allsop. I think this one might just be a draw.
What you showed us completely revolutionised how we were thinking that one day, if we were to move, we're going to be going further out. So I think the idea would be to go to potentially a home county, or, you know, it might be a little bit longer on the train, but it would be a complete change of, you know, our lifestyle.
And
I think that's a good result.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah. Thank you.
Well done.
Well, it's been a bit of a roller coaster, but it's a happy ending for Gareth and Tina, and of course, last drinks for me and Madam.
It is lovely.
It is lovely. Yeah.
But 11.50 for a beer and a gin and tonic with no ice, that's enough to drive anyone out of London.
You've not got any ice in it.
No.
I've got a big smile on my face every time I walk in. And every time I walk out to the garden and I see this lovely little garden in Zone 1, hear the birds chirping, I'm happy, very happy.
Good result for them.
Good result for them.
They like the flat enough to keep it long-term and rent it, and they learnt enough from their time with me to know that they're going to move further out when the time comes.
Good result for them.
Yeah.
I think Kirstie won you over and Phil won me over, so what does that make it?
It's a draw.
It's a draw for Gareth and Tina.
Steward's inquiry.
Is it a draw for Phil and I, or have I got the highest score?
She did know what the drinks cost. Just saying.
Do you think it was a draw?
Let us know at the hashtag on screen.
And if you'd like our help in deciding whether to love or list, apply at channel4.com. Take part.
Next Thursday at 8, we've contactless payment changing our spending habits. Mary Portis takes a look at how Brits are spending and what Britain buys. Later here on 4, regretful piercing is just one of many body modifications gone wrong in Body Shockers. And next, we follow caring staff with a heartwarming inside Birmingham Children's Hospital.
Having big backyards with fruit trees and loved it.
They left London to work in India 10 years ago, but now they're back with two children and a headache about where to base themselves.
You're the one that wanted to move back here in the first place.
I wanted to move back to the UK. Yeah. This was a stepping stone.
So you just dangled a carrot to get me back here.
Yes, very, very clever of me.
Mum Tina thinks the setting is perfect for a busy working family.
One of the big things I love about this place is the fact that it still allows us to get the kids to school and for me to walk to work. I know that it will take me half an hour door to door, guaranteed.
But Dad Gareth dreams of a bigger home in the suburbs.
I feel that a family home is, how I grew up. It's either a semi or it's a detached house with a little bit more space and a nice greenery around it. I don't see us growing up and growing old here together.
I think a family home is wherever your family is. You make the most of where you are.
I don't even like gardening, but I see myself mowing the lawn on a Sunday.
I bet the novelty of that will wear off very quickly and he'll be on his phone trying to get a guy in.
Nothing wrong with getting a guy in, except last time they tried to renovate, it didn't work out well and they abandoned the project.
It's no great secret that I am immensely indecisive, especially when it comes to big decisions like this.
Fear not, we're here to help.
Oh, look, here's someone coming. They've come right down to greet us. That's very civilised.
What do you think? They buzz us in.
Yes. Hello. Hi, nice to meet you.
Good morning.
How are you?
Hello.
We're very well, thank you.
Hi. How are you doing? Nice to meet you.
Oh, this is great. We haven't done a flat before.
Well, welcome.
We're excited to see
you. You're here to help, are you?
Well, allegedly.
I'm here to help. She's just here for glamour.
Someone needs to make an effort, Phil. This flat is full of potential, with three bedrooms upstairs and the garage space and living areas downstairs, which is how the family tend to come and go, through the garden right onto the bank of the Thames.
A beautiful river indeed, but they do have to share it with London's 8.6 million other inhabitants.
So what's the trouble? What's the problem?
The core problem is city versus suburb. That's what you're going to face, right? I would like to move to the suburbs. I think it's time to grow as a family. And for me, it's just not a home.
very, very sensible words,
I think so.
Absolutely spot on. What could be the problem? Tina, why are you so set on being here?
To me, it's more about the kids and how I would work that with the kids. I love the location. Here, you can walk to every activity. She's got swimming, she's got trampoline, she's got ballet, she's got drama, all within a 5-minute...
Will you love it?
Or list it?
Is there a third option? Both?
Mm-hmm.
Can you let it?
Yes, absolutely you could let it.
Listing or letting in the future, when we think it's not working any longer for our family, for our girls, for schooling.
But for the moment, where we are right now in our lives, we're gonna love it.
We're both working, it works for us, the girls are happy.
And this is now a place that I'm super happy to be.
Which is great, because you're both on the same page, finally.
That is something to celebrate. Here's to being on the same page.
Well done.
Cheers.
Sorry, Phil. Technically, that's my fifth love it.
Not so fast, Allsop. I think this one might just be a draw.
What you showed us completely revolutionised how we were thinking that one day, if we were to move, we're going to be going further out. So I think the idea would be to go to potentially a home county or, you know, it might be a little bit longer on the train, but it would be a complete change of, you know, our lifestyle.
And
I think that's a good result. Great. Well, congratulations.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well done.
Well, it's been a bit of a roller coaster, but it's a happy ending for Gareth and Tina, and of course, last drinks for me and Madam.
It is lovely.
It is lovely. Yeah.
But 11.50 for a beer and a gin and tonic with no ice, that's enough to drive anyone out of London.
You've not got any ice in it.
No.
I've got a big smile on my face every time I walk in. And every time I walk out to the garden and I see this lovely little garden in Zone 1, hear the birds chirping, I'm happy, very happy.
Good result for them.
Good result for them.
They like the flat enough to keep it long-term and rent it, and they learnt enough from their time with me to know that they're going to move further out when the time comes.
Good result for them.
Yeah.
I think Kirstie won you over and Phil won me over, so... What does that make it?
It's a draw.
It's a draw for Gareth and Tina.
Stewards inquiry.
Is it a draw for Phil and I, or have I got the highest score?
She did know what the drinks cost. Just saying.
Do you think it was a draw?
Let us know at the hashtag on screen.
And if you'd like our help in deciding whether to love or list, apply at channel4.com. Take part.
Next Thursday at 8, we've contactless payment changing our spending habits.
This place is amazing. When you're young professionals, why wouldn't you want to live here? But to your point, maybe it's not our forever home.
Square footage does not necessarily make for a better family life.
I can't help noticing there's one thing missing that I was expecting. Where's the hot tub? You said there was going to be a hot tub. But I showed you a house with a blooming great swimming pool.
You did. That was beautiful.
And it opened our eyes, didn't it?
It did. And it was just going to some of those places that we would never have considered.
Go on, Phil. Get it opened up.
Okay. At the end of all of this, will you love it?
Or list it?
Is there a third option? Both?
Mm-hmm.
Can you let it?
Yes, absolutely you could let it.
Listing or letting in the future, when we think it's not working any longer for our family, for our girls, for schooling.
But for the moment, where we are right now in our lives, we're gonna love it.
We're both working, it works for us, the girls are happy.
And this is now a place that I'm super happy to be.
Which is great, because you're both on the same page, finally.
That is something to celebrate. Here's to being on the same page.
Well done.
Cheers.
Sorry, Phil. Technically, that's my fifth love it.
Not so fast, Allsop. I think this one might just be a draw.
What you showed us completely revolutionised how we were thinking that one day, if we were to move, we're going to be going further out. So I think the idea would be to go to potentially a home county or, you know, it might be a little bit longer on the train, but it would be a complete change of, you know, our lifestyle.
And
I think that's a good result. Great.
Well, congratulations. Yep.
Thank you.
Well done.
Well, it's been a bit of a roller coaster, but it's a happy ending for Gareth and Tina, and of course, last drinks for me and Madam.
It is lovely.
It is lovely. Yeah.
But 11.50 for a beer and a gin and tonic with no ice, that's enough to drive anyone out of London.
You've not got any ice in it.
No.
I've got a big smile on my face every time I walk in. And every time I walk out to the garden and I see this lovely little garden in Zone 1, hear the birds chirping, I'm happy, very happy.
Good result for them.
Good result for them.
They like the flat enough to keep it long-term and rent it, and they learnt enough from their time with me to know that they're going to move further out when the time comes.
Good result for them.
Yeah.
I think Kirstie won you over and Phil won me over, so... what does that make it?
It's a draw.
It's a draw.
Come and go, through the garden, right onto the bank of the Thames.
A beautiful river indeed, but they do have to share it with London's 8.6 million other inhabitants.
So what's the trouble? What's the problem?
The core problem is city versus suburb. That's what you're going to face, Ryan. I would like to move to the suburbs. I think it's time to grow as a family. And for me, it's just not a home.
Very, very sensible words.
I think so.
Absolutely spot on. What could be the problem? Tina, why are you so set on being here?
To me, it's more about the kids and how I would work that with the kids. I love the location. Here, you can walk to every activity. She's got swimming, she's got trampoline, she's got ballet, she's got drama, all within a 5-minute walk.
As a working mum who managed to drop her kids at school this morning and got the tube here, what you've just said is absolutely the thing. And if Phil could find a property near enough that you were still able to do that, then that's amazing.
Phil's the man, right?
That I am, Gareth. And because this flat was bought so long ago, and this is central London where house prices have risen by up to 65% in just the last 8 years, if the family did sell up and pursue a life away from the big smoke, they'd have a budget of £1.1 million to work with.
That's a huge amount of money, but as many have found to their peril, our capital doesn't get you much bang for your buck. Plus, on top of that, Tina and Gareth would be shelling out just under £54,000 in stamp duty and another £20,000 or so in legal and moving costs.
I think that you are going to really, really struggle.
They can now afford a bigger property.
Yeah, but
so
why
are they crunched in here,
but they're
with
not
four
crushed, but
living
actually,
in this room, no playroom?
No, but Phil, that's what's absolutely extraordinary, and this is at the heart of everyone's property dilemmas. Square footage does not guarantee better family life.
What? You mean size isn't everything?
You know the first thing I would do if I were them?
What?
You're going to laugh. I'm going to tell you this. This is absolutely the first thing I would do. I would get a hot tub. There's nothing children like more than a hot tub.
Privacy or what?
No,
I mean, about a million people could look.
Suit. It doesn't matter. You're in a bathing suit in a hot tub.
Oh, come on.
I had no idea you were so shy, Phil. I'm sure you look lovely in your budgie smugglers.
I can't get away from, and I shouldn't because I know there'll be lots of families living around here, but it's very densely, very densely populated.
But Phil, you're a Kentish person. You're a man of Kent.
Gareth
and you
is
think
in the
happiness
same spot.
Is rolling acres of green, green grass.
I wish he wouldn't say it like that. He wants it to feel homely and spacious for his girls.
And why would I not be able to do that?
Because it's small.
He wants to feel proud.
If a house that's worth more than £800,000 can't make you feel proud, then frankly, we should all be moving to the suburbs.
It's very well designed. There's three or four things I need to do.
One of her more bonkers ideas was she's going to set you up with a hot tub in the garden.
Right.
She thinks that'll entertain the children forever. No, I say it will entertain about a million neighbours.
Well, you're just a prude. You're a snob, you're obsessed with being in the country.
Hey,
and you're
listen,
a prude.
I'm trying to help, not throw insults around the house.
I'm glad someone bickers more than us.
They've given me a Love It budget of £75,000, which is roughly what they'd spend on moving costs and taxes. The garage is full of potential, and I have big ideas for that small kitchen. I also need to address the dated bathrooms.
At the very least, it'll make this place more saleable when they do decide to list it.
We have to sort this out. I'm not convinced it's for the long term. You're in a good position in life and you've got a nice budget, and we can go and explore and find you what you could get.
With a budget of around 1.1 million, I need to find a family home with four bedrooms and green space. High-achieving schools are a must for Gareth, but I also have to keep Tina within a 30 to 40-minute commute of her work in central London. Easy, right?
I think Phil's going to find a wonderful place and is really going to change your mind.
Can't move location.
Everyone is really digging in.
No, they're not digging in. You keep on saying, you're both so entrenched.
Well, no, you're really digging in. She's really digging in.
They're
boys
not
against
entrenched.
Girls at this point.
It's not boys against girls. No, not anybody against anybody.
Mm. Kirstie's going to do up this place beautifully.
They have a dilemma which we need to sort out. I think the real issue is your urban snobbery.
She's so full of
sugar and spice and all things nice.
To make me consider moving from here, Phil would have to come up with something fairly spectacular.
She believes the space is good enough and big enough, and I disagree.
In Wapping, East London, a young family are torn between city centre convenience and the seduction of suburban space.
We go to our friends' houses, some people have just bought outside of central London. I have house envy, I have home envy more than anything.
Phil was definitely going to have his work cut out. It's the location, that's the issue for me. You can't move the location.
Precisely. I think they should stay. So it's my mission to transform this tired flat into a functioning family home so they can love it once more.
Do you know, it is really amazing to have this space. Phil's not going to be able to find a house with a garage this size. Or off-street parking.
That's not entirely true. Higher in the Thames, with a flat of all things.
It's in the super central district of Wapping, where a three-bed terrace can set you back £1 million, and prices have leapt by 11% in the last year alone.
Mind you, driving's a nightmare, as is my navigator.
You're the one with the most opinions on which way we're supposed to be going.
I think we're here somewhere. It's quite complicated.
Are you lost, Phil, in Wapping?
Well, I'm following your directions, so if I'm
lost,
then
it's your problem.
Oh, I didn't
say. I believe I said try that way or that way, which doesn't specify as directions.
Not an awful lot of help to then accuse me of getting it wrong.
I didn't ever see the memo which said be of help to Phil.
I would hope that you wouldn't have to see a memo be of help to Phil, eh?
Actually, Phil, I am here to help, as are you, because project manager Gareth Hearn, wife Tina and admin manager are struggling to make one very big decision.
I can't see us growing up here as a family at all.
I feel that this place works.
They might be at loggerheads now, but when they bought this two-storey apartment in 2006, they were on the same page.
They scrimped, saved and managed to secure it for £395,000, renting out the spare bedrooms to help make their dreams come true.
I remember when we first got the keys and I came to the little backyard and I was sitting there and I was like, I can't believe I own a little place, we own a little place in London that's got an apple tree in the backyard. Because growing up in New Zealand, it's all about having big backyards with fruit trees and I loved it, loved it.
They left London to work in India 10 years ago, but now they're back with two children and a headache about where to base themselves.
You're the one that wanted to move back here in the first place.
I wanted to move back to the UK. Yeah. This was a stepping stone.
So you just dangled a carrot to get me back here.
Yes, very, very clever of me.
Mum Tina thinks the setting is perfect for a busy working family.
One of the big things I love about this place is the fact that it still allows us to get the kids to school and for me to walk to work. I know that it will take me half an hour door to door, guaranteed.
But Dad Gareth dreams of a bigger home in the suburbs.
I feel that a family home is, how I grew up. It's either a semi or it's a detached house with a little bit more space and a nice greenery around it. I don't see us growing up and growing old here together.
I think a family home is wherever your family is. You make the most of where you are.
I don't even like gardening, but I see myself mowing the lawn on a Sunday.
I bet the novelty of that will wear off very quickly.
That's very civilised.
What do you think? It buzzes.
Yes. Hello. Hi, nice to meet you.
Good morning.
You.
Nice
hello.
Morning. Hello.
How are you doing? We're very well, thank you.
Hi. How are you doing? Nice
How'd
to meet you.
Oh, this is great. We haven't done a flat before.
Well, welcome.
We're excited to see
you're here to help,
it.
Are you?
Well, we, yeah, allegedly.
I'm here, to, help. Here to help. She's just here for glamour.
Someone needs to make an effort, Phil. This flat is full of potential, with three bedrooms upstairs and the garage space and living areas downstairs, which is how the family tend to come and go, through the garden right onto the bank of the Thames.
A beautiful river indeed, but they do have to share it with London's 8.6 million other inhabitants.
So what's the trouble? What's the problem?
The core problem is city versus suburb. That's what you're going to face, right? I would like to move to the suburbs. I think it's time to grow as a family. And for me, it's just not a home.
Very, very sensible words.
I think so.
Absolutely spot on. What could be the problem? Tina, why are you so set on being here?
To me, it's more about the kids and how I would work that with the kids. I love the location. Here, you can walk to every activity. She's got swimming, she's got trampoline, she's got ballet, she's got drama. All within a 5-minute walk.
As a working mum who managed to drop her kids at school this morning and got the tube here, what you've just said is absolutely the thing. And if Phil could find a property near enough that you were still able to do that, then that's amazing.
Phil's the man, right?
That I am, Gareth. And because this flat was bought so long ago, and this is central London where house prices have risen by up to 65% in just the last 8 years, if the family did sell up and pursue a life away from the big smoke, they'd have a budget of £1.1 million to work with.
That's a huge amount of money, but as many have found to their peril, our capital doesn't get you much bang for your buck. Plus, on top of that, Tina and Gareth would be shelling out just under £54,000 in stamp duty and another £20,000 or so in legal and moving costs.
I think that you are going to really, really struggle.
They can now afford a bigger property.
Yeah, but
so
why
are they crunched in here
but they're
with
not
four
crushed, but,
living
actually,
in this room? No playroom?
No, but Phil, that's what's absolutely extraordinary. And this is at the heart of everyone's property dilemmas. Square footage does not guarantee better family life.
What? You mean size isn't everything?
You know the first thing I would do if I were them?
What?
You're going to laugh. I'm going to tell you this. This is absolutely the first thing I would do. I would get a hot tub. There's nothing children like more than a hot tub.
Privacy or what?
No,
I mean, about a million
you're
people
bathing
could look.
Suit. It doesn't matter. You're in a bathing suit.
From the train station.
What's not to like, eh?
Oh, it's like a half an hour to get into London.
There's got to be a catch. I keep saying it, but there's got to be something wrong with it.
No, just a stunning extended Victorian property set in a family-orientated location that even hosts its own street party every year. It's split over three levels. Downstairs, it boasts two large reception rooms, including an incredible kitchen dining space similar to the spec of the Greenwich property they like so much. Upstairs, there are four beds and a beautiful family bathroom. Out back, there's a great-sized garden perfect for Jacinta and Kayla. And at £950,000, it's £150,000 under budget.
Because I love the flow of this place. It's been extended out back here into something that I'd say is quite special.
Oh, it's got one of these.
I think they've done a really, really good job on it. Loads of space. Look at the size of that wine fridge. Coffee machine. You know, it's a very well specced out place. Look at that. Could you see yourself here?
Oh, yeah.
Entertaining family and friends. You're trying... Now you're trying not to like it. Your gut reaction was you loved it, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
And now you're going, what am I letting myself in for?
No, it is lovely.
This is a beautiful room. This is a bit like, you know, for... you entertaining.
Seen you at the
vet? Yes, I have.
Crikey, Tina's enthused, and I'm shocked.
If you wanted to find a criticism, that's it. That is the railway. But it is an electric railway, yeah. So it's not noisy.
Mm-hmm. I'd have to hear it, but I haven't heard anything so far.
What the lady wants...
Here we come.
Oh, my gosh, that is nothing. That is nothing.
That's nothing, is it?
Yeah, that was crazy.
It's not going to wake a sleeping child. It's not going to disturb you whilst you're in the garden.
And there's more.
Palm tree?
Well, you know, I had to bring an Antipodean little bit into it. Ran in here this morning and planted that for you. There's a gum tree down the end, you know. Got it all going on. Well, they both are being really positive and upbeat, particularly Tina. She's the one that doesn't want to move. But then I have found a really nice house within a 30-minute commute door-to-door, so... could all be going my way.
There is one minor drawback, though.
Yeah, so it's one bathroom. But nice bathroom.
Very nice bathroom. Two toilets.
Yeah.
Toilet.
Yeah.
Best one yet, by far, I think.
I agree, but have I done enough to...
It's convinced me.
I like this house and I like all the things it brings to the table, the off-street parking, the private road, the nice big garden, the train doesn't bother me. I'm really enthusiastic.
Kirstie said it couldn't be done, and I've managed to find the right house within the 30-minute commute time.
I don't know about you, but I love it.
I mean, Phil has done an amazing job.
Yeah, I think this is the one house out of the three that I would actually consider, you know, buying.
Yeah, I agree, I agree.
Hang on, Tina. You've not seen the finished product at home yet.
We're back in Wapping, as today, project manager Gareth Hares and his wife, admin manager Tina Woodger, will finally settle their argument over city versus suburbs.
I feel that this place works.
I can't see us growing up here as a family at all.
To convince Gareth to love their flat by the Thames, the last 9 weeks have been spent remodelling it in order to create the perfect home for a family of four.
It's very unusual to see my house like this or our house like this.
Wait, is this our bathroom?
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I've tried to sell Tina on the many, many benefits of moving to a new way of life.
That is the nursery.
Very good, very good.
That's the first smile of the day.
But with the renovation complete and the score standing at four loves to Phil's three lists, we're both desperate to know what Gareth and Tina plan to do now.
There's the building.
The flat.
You'll be amazed, Phil.
Well, you'd be amazed if you could see the houses I showed them. Well, they were amazed.
And how long would it take me to get to those houses?
Yeah, one of them was half an hour. A couple of them were half an hour.
You would get to the station, wait for the train, get on the train.
Well...
I know you're quite confident about this, Phil.
Well, and I wouldn't say confident, but I'm really... chipperness. I am hopeful, yes. I am definitely
but
hopeful.
But I think your chipperness is going to end up in the chipper.
Right. What's this? For all, here we come. Come on, baby, come on. Move out of this flat.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
Oh, look.
Hi.
Oh, two people in their business suits.
Looking very smart.
That's because they live close to their place of
work.
Yeah,
all right.
Indeed,
come on.
Exactly. I had to walk back.
When we first met Gareth and Tina, like many city dwellers, they had a fabulous location, but not a lot of space. And with daughters, Jacinta and Kayla, growing up fast, the problem was only getting worse. Though where things really came unstuck was in that small, dark and family-unfriendly kitchen. But now...
Although, perhaps I showed my hand too soon.
A little old-fashioned with the attire.
I just wouldn't pay extra for period features, like some people love period features. I just don't know if it's our style.
Tina, what are your thoughts?
I guess if this was a house that was completely done up and you walked in and went, wow, you wouldn't have to do a thing, that would be more appealing for me. It's not the commute that's put me off. It's more the amount of work that would need to be done.
But it's nothing that you wouldn't expect of a house of this age. I wanted to show you this as an example. If you commuted a little bit further,
yeah,
that what you could get.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It really is crazy.
Yeah.
So period style is not to their taste, but if the work transforming it into a contemporary home is Tina's only concern, then this viewing has been a big success.
I'm really happy with my opening gambit because it stimulated some proper debate between them. Before, Tina was adamant she would not commute more than 30 minutes, and now they're discussing it. So I think it's gone well.
And I know exactly what to show them for property number two. Prepare to be wowed, Tina.
In Wapping, I've been hard at work coming up with a design that will make Tina and Gareth love their flat again.
It works, this kitchen. But it's dark, it's tucked away, it's not very friendly. You know, you've got your back to everybody. So I think what I want to do is kind of draw it into the light.
To transform this professional's pad into a loving family home for four, I'm working to a budget of £75,000.
This is your flat. It is huge.
Huge.
Huge for London, huge for within the M25, actually.
Space isn't the only issue here. The problem is that this flat has not been designed with a family in mind. But it's all very fixable. A simple rejig of the bedrooms will create more space, and two updated bathrooms will modernise the upstairs no end. Downstairs, by adding a stud wall to their underutilised garage, I'll be creating two spaces, one offering masses of storage and the other an indoor play area for the girls, perfect for hobbies, as it will come complete with an insulated timber floor. And finally, their old kitchen is going to be replaced and extended into the current living room, transforming mealtimes into a sociable family occasion.
In terms of what I'm suggesting, does anything fill you with horror?
No. I'm impressed. I like the idea that it will come in at less money.
Making use of this area, it just makes it a little bit bigger. It makes it more like a, you know, three bedrooms upstairs and the space of three bedroom kind of flat downstairs.
Assess again, as the former garage has been divided in two, giving mum and dad masses of storage and the girls a play area for Britain's odd rainy day.
Okay.
So this is the garage.
Yes.
It can easily be converted back to garage use. That's just a stud wall, so that
absolutely
comes down.
That was the purpose of the design. But we can also double it up to somewhere if the kids can come in and have a little play if it's raining, or a bit of a hobby room or whatever.
Just a bit more space for the kids.
Yeah.
And upstairs there are more clever space solutions. A brand new bigger family bathroom, plus an ensuite that's doing a better job too.
Very smart ensuite. It's two sinks.
Yeah, a double sink in such a tiny room. That design changed probably about how many times? So many times.
Is that your decisiveness?
Yes.
Or indecisiveness?
Yeah, indecisiveness.
Gareth and Tina aren't alone. Most of us struggle with the hundreds of decisions renovating involves. But my advice is simple.
It would be to go away and to sit down with all the catalogues, with no children and no phones and no distractions, and just make every single decision ahead of time. But also,
and then get rid of the books.
Get rid of the books. Make your decisions.
You said that with feeling.
Yeah. Make the decisions, stick with the decisions. Yeah.
But are you pleased with the decisions that you've taken?
If it makes him happy and gets us to stay, then I'm happy.
Oh, here we go. This is going to be difficult.
Some might say impossible, Phil. And while at £90,000, Gareth and Tina have gone over budget, the good news is that they've added £130,000 or so to the flat's value.
Which means they're in an even stronger position to sell up and move on. Thank you, sweet cheeks. Loving your work.
What you've done is amazing. In a relatively small space, you've made it feel bigger, lighter, more usable, and it's great. But it still begs the question, can it be the long-term family home?
The location of this place is amazing. When you're young professionals, why wouldn't you want to live here? But to your point, maybe it's not our forever home.
Square footage does not necessarily make for a better family life.
I can't help noticing there's one thing missing that I was expecting. Where's the hot tub? You said there was going to be a hot tub. But I showed you a house with a blooming great swimming pool.
You did. That was beautiful.
And it opened our eyes, didn't it?
It did. And it was just going to some of those places that we would never have considered.
Go on, Phil. Get it opened up.
OK. At the end of all of this, will you love it?
Or list it?
Is there a third option? Both?
Mm-hmm.
Can you let it?